either. My name is Big Tigger from V103. Welcome to the Mindful Sport and Performance Retired Players Ball Evening. We are going to celebrate us tonight.
So excited to be dressed up and out of the house, right?
This is an absolutely amazing event. Amazing not only because of all the beauty, the power, and the influence that is in the room, but it is amazing because of the cause for which we are gathered.
We all suffer from mental health in some way, shape, or form. I've been abused. I've dealt with things mentally, emotionally. I've dealt with things physically. I've dealt with things sexually.
And the whole purpose of Mindful Sport and Performance is to let high-profile individuals and everybody, but particularly high-profile individuals, know that you have someone.
So if anybody in this room told me that they weren't experiencing or have ever experienced some form of mental health issues, I'd like for you to grab your fork and your knife right now so you can cut the bullshit out.
You know, and those things are hard to talk about sometimes. It's hard to hear someone tell you what your issues, your problems are, and things that can help you, because we're stubborn and we're competitive and we have this macho mentality about us as athletes that, you know, forces us sometimes to not seek help and think that we have all the answers.
Transitional athletes, sometimes they go through things like depression, substance abuse. This is a platform and a safe space to talk about what do they need and how do we provide that to them.
I played 16 years professional, and after that ended for me, I went into like a 3-year depression. And the mistake that I made was I let basketball determine who I was. So when it was no longer there, I had to figure out who I was. I wasn't prepared for that. 3 years I was in this depression, trying to figure it out, scared to ask for help. Drinking every single day, waking up to the same problems every single day for 3 years. I want to share my experiences with people and be able to talk about it, to be able to ask for help. It took me 3 years to get the courage to go out and ask for help. It was tough on me, and I get emotional.
This thing has come to the forefront. People are talking about it. And once the conversation starts, I think that's when we start to make progress.
Right? And we are no longer Lakers or Celtics or Hawks or Magic. We are just teammates in the retired space of life. So to be able to pick up the telephone, call someone, check on them, provide them a level of support is imperative.
The need for mental health awareness has reached cataclysmic proportions, and at this point, it refuses to be ignored.
It's been around a long time, but we've been afraid to communicate. We've been afraid to educate. We've been afraid to share.
You know, we always talk about being in great physical shape, but if you have the physical but without the mind, you've jacked up. So we want to thank Josh and Jumaine and Sheena for putting together such an event.
Amid the laughter and the joy, we will remember why we are here.
And if you see over there on that wall, there is a QR code. And by the bar, where lots of us will be for the rest of the evening, there is another QR code. So as you are getting a beverage, you can open your phone and literally make a donation. Can we get a round of applause for Sheena and Jumaine and Josh and Jeremy? Putting together a really great evening in the middle of a pandemic. I've been tasked with reminding all of the players that we enjoyed you on the court, and now that you're off the court, we are still here for you. So thank you for your hard work, your dedication. We appreciate you, and now it's time to party. You ain't gotta leave, but you have to turn up. So let's have a good time.